Back in England, pop music had inspired a dazzling new culture. All roads now led to London, as the reign of a new pop aristocracy transformed England's capital into the swingingest city in the world. Out of this euphoric haze appeared The Who. Pete Townsend's group translated the mod preoccupations of swinging London into a musical style as distinctly original as Townsend's notorious Union Jack jacket.
We used to look to the States for everything, for our fashions and for our music. And then all of a sudden, you know, England's fashions and England's sort of music all sort of started to close in. People in London started to like rhythm and blues, you know, which is essentially a good form of music. Groups started to play it, and there was an audience for rhythm and blues. And there was then an audience for sort of original groups.
Love me. not saying that we're better or greater or comparing us with Jesus Christ as a person or God as a thing or whatever it is. You know, I just said what I said and it was wrong or was taken wrong, and now it's all this.
The Beatles began their next American tour amidst a flurry of controversy sparked by John's misinterpreted remark regarding their popularity. No longer mere entertainers, they had become the unwitting spokesman for young people everywhere.
Do you mind being asked questions, for example, in America, people keep asking questions about Vietnam? Does this seem useful?
Well, I don't know. You know, if you can say that war's no good and a few people believe you, then it may be good. I don't know. You can't say it too much, though. That's the trouble.
It seems a bit silly to be in America and for none of them to mention Vietnam as if nothing was happening.
But why should they ask you about it? You're successful entertainer.
That is why they...
Because Americans always ask showbiz people what they think about it. So do the British, you know. Showbiz, you know how it is. But I mean, you've just got to, you can't just keep quiet about anything that's going on in the world unless you're a monk. Sorry, monks, I didn't mean it. I meant actually. Only ever asked to give me love forever and
forever. My love don't give me presents. Still, as they crisscrossed America for the fourth time in 2 years, the screaming tidal wave which met them night after night affirmed their indisputable popularity. Yet touring proved to be a life on the run. The pressured atmosphere left little room for musical progress. Tired of being shuttled from one stage to the next, they yearned for the peace and quiet of the recording studio. Returning to England, the Beatles announced, to the astonishment of their fans, that they had given their last concert.
Why don't you bring a big sign?